Hi guys, if you've been with me for my everyday makeup drawer before, you will know this is a completely different setup. I now have a beauty space and I have a desk, so I actually have everyday makeup drawers now and not just like a cart. Okay, so let's just jump right into it. I will link to my playlist below if you've never been here before. I'm not gonna explain everything at the beginning of the video, but I'm just switching out what I'm using day to day. So all of these foundations are gonna come out. I have my Dior Forever, what is this called? The Forever Perfect Makeup. This is not my favorite foundation, but it's okay, but I've used that a lot. I've also used a lot the CoverGirl Vitalist Healthy Elixir Foundation, so I can put that back. And the Lancome Tint Idol Ultra Stick. This is not my favorite foundation. It's actually very dry on my skin. I don't like the way it looks, but I've been mixing it with the Hourglass Vanish Stick Foundation, which is in my Bought It Forgot It series, so that's not gonna be included in this video, but I've been mixing it and that's how I've been using it. So this is all my brow stuff. That's gonna stay as always. Let's move over to highlighters. So Gilded Honey, I've used quite a bit. That can come out. The Smashbox Casey Holmes Pearl Collab, I've used that a lot. That can come out. I've used this a lot. I love this so much. This is like now become one of my favorite highlighters of all time. This is Sparkling Peach by Lancome. It's just so beautiful. I love it so much. But I've used that a ton, so I'm going to put that away for a while. I've used both of these, the Fairy Highlight and Urban Decay Sin. This is not one of my favorites. I might end up decluttering that at some point, but for now I'm just going to put it back. So that's a makeup use up item. Everything else is blush now, so I use this a lot. This is the Paul and Joe cheek color. That's what that looks like. I use that quite a bit. I use my Hourglass blush palette quite a bit. Too Faced, what is this one again? Baby Love. I used it quite a bit, but I don't love it. It's definitely not a favorite. This is Black Honey Pop from Clinique, which is a really good fall blush. And then Makeup Revolution Vivid Baked Blush and Make Love Instead. And then the other two are also makeup use up. Okay, for primers, I want to keep this Becca Velvet Blurring Primer. I like it so much. It's brand new to me, so I want to keep using that. But I use this a ton, the Smooth and Protect from NARS, which is a huge favorite, but I'll put that back for a while. And then the Cover FX Mattifying Primer, that can go back for a while. These bronzers, yeah, I think I'm going to put both of these back because I did use them both a lot. Like, they were the only two bronzers I had in here. So those can go back. The NYX Stay Matte Not Flat powder, I used a ton. Same with the Maybelline Fit Me. I really ended up liking this. Now that I've got the right shade for me, I really like the way this wears. It's a great drugstore powder. And then this Becca powder, this is the pink one. It's called Pink Haze. I've been using this to set my under eye and I don't love it. I don't think it's worth the price, but maybe I'll talk about that in a update video at some point. And then over here, these three things are makeup use up. My RCMA No Color powder, I've been using that a ton as well to set my under eye. Love it. Okay, I actually brought this concealer in because, why did I bring this in? I can't remember why, but I've used it a couple times now. I want to keep it in for the next rotation because it is still very new and I really like this. I'll be talking about this in my favorites, I'm sure. This Naked Skin Color Corrector is finished. Like, I have been scraping it this week, so I'm glad to switch that out for something else because that's a really good color corrector, but it's done. This Benefit Boing, I don't like this very much, so I'm gonna put that back. And then both these concealers, the Estee Lauder Double Wear, use that a ton, and I've been mixing it with this L'Oreal Infallible. So there's a lot of beauty gurus who have been using this and saying that it burns their eyes. Now, luckily it doesn't burn my eyes, but I still don't love it. It is very light coverage, so I always have to mix it with something a lot more full coverage. So for that reason, it's not a favorite. So this is my new eyeshadow drawer, palettes, singles. I know this is a weird angle, but it's the only way I can get to it. Okay, for all my singles here, I didn't use the purple in this. I kind of want to use it, but maybe I'll save that for another time because I really want to put in some new stuff and I have a lot of eyeshadow that's new. I used both of these, so these can go back, the Tarte Rose Gold and then the Stila Sunset Cove, Armani Eyes to Kill in number 5, which is kind of like a gold, and Kat Von D, this is Synergy. I didn't use this, so I need to put this back in for the next go around and hopefully I can remember to use it. So use this a ton, the Shade and Light palette from Kat Von D. I use this a ton, the number 2 Pro palette from, what's it called, Claire Cosmetics. You guys, I know these are hard to get, but if you ever see Claire Cosmetics anywhere, pick it up. They are such amazing quality. And this is a beautiful fall palette. The mattes are amazing. I love that. Okay, Chocolate Bonbons palette I used a bunch. This is still my makeup use up project. And then the Lila palette from Natasha Denona, I used this a ton as well, so I will put that back. Now these are a bit of a different story. Originally all my ColourPop was mixed in with my Makeup Geek singles, so I'm going to put this back because I did use it, but what happened was I got a bunch of new ColourPop shadows, pretty much like I think the four on this side here. And I want to use those this go around. So I'm gonna keep this in this drawer for now, and then all of these palettes can go back. So this is liners and like lip liners and eyeliners. This NARS one can go back. I use that a bunch. The Estee Edit can go back. I use that one. A bunch of these are makeup use up, so I'm not gonna touch those. This I just put in here. This is actually an eyeliner, but I thought it was a lip liner when I bought it, so I'm just using it as a lip liner. That's been really good for fall. That's called Alkaline. Still haven't used that Bite one. I use this Rouge one a lot. I'm getting into vampire colors. This one can probably go back now. This Essence one, same with... Yeah, same with this one from Wet n Wild and this one from Wet n Wild. I love them, but I haven't been wearing those colors that often, and I pretty much have the same colors in these MAC ones here, and I haven't been touching my MAC as much as I should, so I'm gonna be just using those, hopefully. And then, as always, I've got my lip drawers. So I've already pre-organized these. Everything in this one here I have used, and actually everything in this one, well, except for this one, I've used these, but I want to keep them in one more time. I've got these two new Too Faced Peach Collection. They're both so pretty. One's a neutral and one's like a deep vampy purple. And then this is called Devious from Bare Minerals. And it's just such, I know this is not focusing. It's just such a really nice fall shade. So I just want to keep this in another go around. And I never did get to use this Wet n Wild. So those are going to stay. The rest are going back. So I have a ton of stuff that is new that I don't want to take everything from here because that would be boring for you guys, but there's so much in here that I need to pull out, so I'm gonna have to be kind of choosy. First of all, Nicki Minaj, this is the new Nicki's Nude, which I just got, and I feel like I should test that out. I really want to try this ColourPop No Filter Concealer, which I haven't given a shot yet. Okay, I'm definitely gonna leave some of this stuff in here, but let's pull out some stuff that is like been already waiting in here, like California. I should probably use this. I know it's more of a spring and summer blush, but I don't want to save it till next year, so I should at least try to use it before it gets like deep into fall. Okay, a couple liquid lipsticks. I have this from L'Oreal. It's called Shakedown in their new matte liquid lipsticks. I got this one. I'll save this one till we're a little bit more into fall because that's even vampier. Milani. I could save this palette for next time, that eyeshadow for next time. Oh, I really want to try this highlighter. This is the Skin Kiss from Makeup Revolution in Peach Kiss, and I'll save the gold one for next time. I've got this new ColourPop Misses Ultra Satin Lip, and then, oh yeah, these YSL ones. These are kind of similar shades, so I'll just pull one this time and one the next time. This is number 16. I'll use this one. Got this Shuamura eyeliner from the Mario collaboration. I really, really want to pull out this Flower Beauty powder to cream blush. I've used it once and I was so impressed. And same with this. This is the ColourPop I Think I Love You palette. This is the new Victoria Beckham Estee Lauder eyeshadow that I already hauled. It's quite the packaging for a single eyeshadow. Like, honestly, it's a little bit much just for one eyeshadow, but that is going to be beautiful. This is Stargazer from Anastasia. This has been in here for a while, so I really need to pull that out. This is a new Rouge Dior Double Rouge. Oh yeah, if you didn't see my haul with this, it's really cool because it's got like an inner color and an outer color, so it kind of gives you an ombre effect just as you put it on. And then I also have the Born This Way concealer from Too Faced, which I have never tried, so I want to pull that in. And then let's also pull in this Amore Matte Lip Cream from Milani. This is in the shade Obsession, and actually I should pull this one in too because this has been in here for a while. This is in the shade Loved. So everything else is gonna have to wait till next time. So now this is as well all a new setup. So let's just start up here because these are right in front of me. So I've got all my lip liners up here now. Instead, I used to have all my liquid lipsticks, but you'll see those in a second. I feel like I have enough nudes already over there. So the only ones that I think I need are probably these two. I have Femme Fatale from Essence. And then this one is from Urban Decay. It's called Jilted. It's kind of more of a deep fuchsia. I just had to change my shirt. I was so hot in that sweater. All right, so there's a whole bunch of these. I did a lip swatch video on these and I really liked a bunch of them. So I know I already pulled a lot of lipstick and I have a huge collection, so I need to be careful. I can't really remember what colors these are without looking at them. Okay, I'm gonna pull in Kitty and Searchly Red. That's obviously a red, but this is just kind of a really cool, it's just a really nice nude. I don't like a lot of gloss. I shouldn't even own any gloss, to be honest, but I do want to make use of what I have. So let me just pull in one. This is the Anastasia Gloss in Vintage. I really like this formula. And then over in the liquid lipsticks, I should probably pull in an Anastasia one here too, because I haven't used these in a long time. Let's use Dolce. I really like that shade a lot. So I already have an infallible one. I'll leave those. Maybe I'll bring in the melting pout one in. I'm pulling a lot of nude stuff now in number 105, which is gel full. And then here I've got some NYX, NARS, liquid catsuits. I feel like I can leave all this for now. Yeah, those are good. Bare Minerals. Let's also pull in this one from Bare Minerals in OMG, because this is also a really, really good color for the fall because it's kind of like a deep fuchsia. I also really like this. It's another red, but let's just do it. It's in VIP, and then the rest I will leave. So this is now where I'm keeping all my sticks and my minis. So I'm going to pull in this one from Marc Jacobs. It's called Je T'aime. I've had this for a long time. It's a really nice kind of deep rose shade. This is a little bit of a weird angle, I know, but I'm just gonna leave it like this for now. So let's see up here, is there anything, maybe one of these Wet n Wilds, although I have one already in the flesh. No, I've used those before. So I'm trying to think of what I haven't used in a long time in my collection. So one for sure is this, it's Urban Decay in Rush. And then this is a good time for this shade for the fall. This is NARS. Scarlet Empress. It is, maybe you can see it better like that. It looks very, very deep, but it's actually kind of sheer, so it makes a really good fall shade. And then the last one I'm gonna pull out is Lustering from MAC. I have not used this in a very long time. It's just a really nice everyday shade. So I kind of reorganized this set of drawers. Not totally, but a little bit. So this is still highlighters up here. Let me see if there's anything. I haven't used Becca Moonstone in a long time. So there's Moonstone. Another highlighter I haven't used in a very long time is this one from Physicians Formula. This is the Shimmer Strips. Love this so much. I really love these Blushing Hearts from Makeup Revolution. So why don't I pull this one? Yeah, this is the one called Peachy Pink Kisses. So, so pretty. These are like super intense highlighters. They're gorgeous. And another one I haven't used in a long time is this one. It's from Measurable Difference. I got this in Winners. It's just in the shade pink. It's a really cool tone, light pink highlight. Really beautiful. And then why don't I pull this one out? This is from MAC. It's got Whisper of Guilt and then a blush in here. This is from the Holiday Collection from last year. So that'll be the last highlighter I pull in. I don't have any foundation left over there. And I also used up my makeup use up one. So I could probably stand to bring in four foundations because I know I'll be able to get some use out of each of them if I bring in four. So let's start with the Estee Lauder Double Wear Nude. That would be good to try out some more now that the weather has cooled down a little bit. Hardly ever touch these BB creams over here, but I'm gonna pull in the CoverGirl Clean Matte BB Cream. Haven't used that in a long time, really like it. Another one I haven't used in a while is my Tint Miracle from Lancome, and this one is probably now my oldest of all my foundations. I know it hasn't gone bad or anything, but I do want to try to use this up. It's really hard to tell because it's been laying on its side how much is in here, but it's probably half gone, so I should try to use this as often as I can. I need to pull one I know for sure is mattifying, so I'm gonna grab the L'Oreal Infallible, but you know what? even though this is gonna make a fifth one, I wanna pull in the Pro Glow as well, and I wanna try mixing them together because I never did try doing that, and I probably won't use this one too much, but I just wanna at least test it once or twice to see what it's like to mix them together. Okay, so this is my single eyeshadow drawer. I know there's a few palettes I wanna pull in, so I don't wanna bring in too much from here. Really, I only wanna bring in stuff if I know for sure I haven't used it in a long time and it needs to be used. Here's a good example. This is NARS Stud. I love this shade, it's gorgeous. And I don't think I've used this since like at least the spring, maybe even like January. So definitely gonna pull that one in. Same with Amber Rush from L'Oreal. I don't think I've used this since the spring, so that needs some love. I've got these sticks from Laura Mercier. I know I love Moonlight because that's the one I always grab for. Yeah, that one's Moonlight. I actually think I'm gonna pull both of these in because maybe I can use them together in an eye look, so let's do that. And then I got these mini palettes over here, but I'm pretty sure everything there has been touched recently, so I think we're good for now. This is concealers, primers, and eyeliners, which is random, I know. I need a color corrector, so let's go for this one, the Hard Candy Cushion Wonder. I love this. I already have two concealers in the drawer already, so I'm just gonna pull in this one from NARS. This is the Soft Matte Complete Concealer. Such a good concealer. I love it so much. So let's pull that in. I only kept one primer. Let's pull in two minis because I want to try to use them up. This is the Meteorites from Guerlain. I can't use this in the summer because I'm too oily in the summer, but I can use it now in the fall. Same with this, the Too Faced Hangover. Let's pull that in too, same reason. It's very hydrating. I don't need it in the summer at all. I'm also gonna pull in this. This is the Urban Decay Optical Illusion. I really, really, really like this. It's fairly new still. And should that be good? I kind of am tempted to pull this in, but both of those are hydrating, so I don't really need that. Actually, yeah, that should be good for now. And as for liner, I'm pretty sure I have everything covered. So it's really just a matter of, do I want to use anything out of here? Because I haven't used it in a while. And I'm thinking, yes, I'll pull in these two things. I've got this from Urban Decay. It's called Desperation. It's a gray. And then this is from Estee Lauder. It's called Night Violet, and that's a purple. Sorry again for the weird angle. I'm still figuring things out. So I know I kept my Makeup Use Up blushes, which are two, and then I have two from my new stuff. That's four. I need about eight for 3 weeks because I've tried it with like six, and I started getting tired of stuff. So let's do eight. So I need four more things from this drawer. Okay. I want to pull this in and see if I like it because this to me, like, it's a really pretty blush. This is, oh, it's so soft. This is like a burnt apricot kind of shade called Spice Cider from Laura Mercier. And I just don't think these shades look the best on me. So this will be a chance to give it a try, see if I like it. This LA Girl, this is the Just Blushing in Just Rosy. It's kind of a deeper rose, so good for this time of year. It's been a while since I pulled in MAC stuff. So let's see. Let's pull in this. This is the Mariah Carey collaboration. This is in the shade Sweet Sweet Fantasy. I really like this, and I also really like this, and I haven't used this in months. This is Sweet Vision Magic Dust Powder from the Nutcracker collection from last holiday. It's got this gold reflect to it. It's so pretty. So I've got brows, bronzer, and contour in this drawer here. So for bronzer, I definitely need something because I put both those back. I'm going to pull in this, the Body Shop Honey Bronzer. This is in medium? Yeah, medium matte. Really good for the fall because it's a little bit lighter on me. And then, what haven't I used in a while? I don't have a ton of bronzer, so there's not a lot to pick from, but that's okay because it means stuff's getting used. I'm going to pull in the Glam Bronzer from L'Oreal again because this is really pretty. I really like it. So let's use that. And then for contour, I want to use the Wet n Wild Cushion Contour, and how about Hoola from Benefit, because I haven't used Hoola in a while as well, so that'll be good for contour. And then brows, that's pretty much covered, except I just, my Gimme Brow got old, so I threw that away, and I need another setting gel. Why can't I think of the word? I need a new brow gel in there. So let's use this. This is from Anastasia, the clear brow gel, but this is like a travel or trial size, so I don't know how long that'll last, but I'll pull that in. So setting powders are all down here now, and I think I've put everything back except for my makeup use up. I'm gonna pull this in. This is a little bit hydrating, so I don't like to use it in the summer. This is called Soft Luminance. It's kind of like a glowy, loose setting powder for the face, but that's not good for the under eye, so I need something else for the under eye. So I'll pull in the Kat Von D Locket Powder in Translucent. Haven't used this in a long time. This is the Super Stay Better Skin Powder in the shade 25 Nude Beige, so that can be a good face setting powder as well. And let's also just pull this in. This is the Cover FX Translucent Light. I can't remember if I like this or not, but it's so tiny, it'd be good to use it up anyway. So I'll pull that in for setting my under eye as well. I know it's really hard to see this, but beside my drawer down here, I'm keeping like small palettes and palettes that I do not use very often. So I'm not gonna pull from this very much, and today I'm not, but I just wanted to show you guys. So I've already got my single ColourPop shadows, and then I have the ColourPop I Think I Love You palette. Also brand new, but I put it up here, is this. It's the Kat Von D Saint and Sinner palette. And I did a collab tutorial on this palette. These doors though, they are a little annoying, I have to say. But the shades in here, I was using mainly this side, so I didn't get to play at all in this side, so I need to pull this in. Well, I want to pull it in, and I really want to experiment more with the Sinner side. Oh, you know what? I want to pull this back in. I love this palette so much, and I did use it a lot when I got it, but I really want to use this more this time of year. So this is the Sephora Pro Editorial palette. These are still available. They are limited edition, but they're still available. I also think this is a good time of year to pull out the Colored Rain Queen of Hearts palette. These are just gorgeous fall shades, so yeah, really good time to use this. And also, this is my MAC Singles Z palette. What I'm gonna do with this is I'm gonna combine this with my ColourPop shadows, because there's enough room in that big Z palette, but I'm not gonna count that as my fourth palette. I'm just letting you know I'm gonna do that. And then why don't we pull in this? Because I had to really fight with myself to put these away, and I love this palette. This is the Basic Bitch palette from MAC. These are brand new. They're still available. I love this palette so much. And that's good from here for now. So there's two things I forgot to include that I want to pull in. This is from Essence. It's the Extreme Lasting Pencil in Silky Nude. And then this is from NYX. It's called That's the Point. It's a new eyeliner, and it's kind of like a Sharpie, like you could see. It's really weird, but anyway, that's brand new, so I want to give that a try. But this is what everything looks like now. 3, 2, 1. This is what everything looks like now that we've changed it all over. So we've got highlighter, blush, foundation, brows, and then over here we got powder, bronzer, concealer, primer, and some more powder and contour. Over here are all the palettes, and then single shadows. And then this highlighter is the only thing I can't find a spot for. I think I'll put it with the bronzer, but it's really big, so it's not fitting in the highlighter drawer. So hopefully you guys like this series now that it's kind of a little bit more organized, I would say, because I have actual drawers now. If you're new around here, definitely subscribe. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. That helps me out so much. And that's it for today. I love you guys. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.